this video we'll look into how can we compare means between two groups of data using MATLAB. I'm going to cover very simply the parametric test and the non-parametric test, specifically the t-test and the Wilcoxon rank sum test. To conduct a t-test in MATLAB, we can use the t-test2 function. First, let me clear the window. I need to have some sample data to perform this t-test. So let me just load up the sample data set in MATLAB, win. And I'm going to use U and V, the first matrix of this multidimensional variable. So to conduct the t-test, I just need to specify the two outputs of the function. That's called the first one H, which stands for hypothesis, and then the second one is P, the p-value, equals to the function t-test2, and the first group that we would like to compare, U, all of the rows, the first column of the first matrix, against V, all of the rows, the first column of the first matrix. Press enter, and that's it. You've compared between two means. Here we see that the null hypothesis cannot be rejected. Then we have to accept the null hypothesis, which means that there's not much difference. There's no significant difference between U and V. The p-value here is more than 0.05, so it shows that it is not significant. The difference is not significant between U and V. Now, to conduct a non-parametric test, the Wilcoxon rank sum test, we use the rank sum function. So again, this function outputs two values, the p-value and the hypothesis. But now the p-value is the first output and the hypothesis is the second output. And just like for t-tests, we need to give the first variable that we like to compare, and then the second variable. Press enter. So the p-value is more than 0.05, which means that we have to accept the null hypothesis, which means that the medians are the same. And this also is reflected in the p-value, which is more than 0.05. So that's it for this very simple video on the t-test and the Wilcoxon rank sum test. If you find it useful, then consider giving a like. If you have any questions or comments, then write in the comment section below. I'll see you in the next video.